gentlemen. My name is Harris New. This is an article I wrote, I think, around 3 years ago. That's in the summer. I took the boat from the Richmond Fraser River Park, crossing the UBC University, and we turned right into the Fourth Creek, crossing Granville Island and many, you know, the sense word and other the beautiful the thing, and we also the crossing the English Bay and the Stanley Park. The destination is the, you know, the Canada place. All of the other side is the North Shore. So at that time, because I came here 17 years ago, so this article is just express my feeling for Vancouver. It's a beautiful Vancouver and a warm and a lovely Vancouver. So that's just talk about the background. So, but you know, the whole article is hard to translate the English because I wrote that in Chinese word. So I just tell you the brief the background and the, so I just read some of them because a little bit long. Sorry, I read it that in Chinese word. So the 标题的题目是在中文叫做温润之城，是我三年前写的一篇散文，所以呢，感谢Sophia邀请我来参加这个活动，所以呢，这段时间很忙，没有时间尽可心来写这文章，所以我把三年前的一篇旧作呢，这个给大家呈现，给大家，我读其中的一部分，因为稍微长一点，不耽误大家时间，这个题目本身是温润之城。 在中文的角度来说，我读其中的后面一段，就是说，我最后一段就是，我说不是所有人都知道北京遇见西雅图中的90%的取景都是在温哥华拍摄的，如歌的年华、碧海蓝天、雪山草地、参天大树、和煦的阳光，春天的樱花之城、夏天的玫瑰焰火之约、秋天的枫叶之情、冬天的初雪之恋。 温华没有惊世骇俗的美丽，有的只是细腻入微的温文尔雅。只有你亲自走过和品尝那许许多多不同的街角的咖啡店，你才会遇到你不曾遇见的温华，才会体会出你自己手写和手绘的温华。刚刚抓上来的螃蟹的清蒸美味和无敌的海景都会幻化成风，消失在时光的隧道。岁月极美，在于它必然的流逝。 世界这么大，人生这么长，总会有这么一个人让你想要温柔的对待。温润之城的温哥华会不会让你遇人白首，则已成终老，爱向水墨青花，何惧刹那芳华 ？Thank you. Just talk about the part of the So the Vancouver is lovely. From the season to season, no matter the summer or the spring, and also the autumn and the winter, so that's a different season, a different the beautiful view. So we all the immigrants from the different worlds, we all thanks to the Vancouver for us and thanks to the Canada, give us all the things. Thank you.